I think it's about time, according to that clock. Well, according to the clock on the wall, it's time. I'd like to call the regular City Commission meeting of Tuesday, September 8th, 2015, to order. And the first item, if you would please stand and join me for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. First item is the agenda. Is there a motion to accept the agenda? Or has anyone want to make any change?
Mr. Mayor, I'll make a motion to accept the agenda for tonight's meeting.
Second.
Discussion, questions, corrections, changes? Hearing none. Okay.
Go ahead.
Do you want to make a comment about it?
No. Oh, I'll okay. wait till the agenda ends.
Okay. All in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Approved. Agenda is approved. Next item is approval of minutes of the meeting of Tuesday, August 18th.
Mr. Mayor, I'll make a motion to approve the minutes as presented.
Second.
Any corrections, comments from anybody? Hearing done, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Next is communications. We do have a letter from, this is a letter to Maureen Elliott for Beaumont Health, thanking them for their $2,500 donation in support of our senior disabled transportation program. You know, we have the arrangement with SMART that we get the buses and we can use them for seniors. And I think it's a good idea, and I think it's very, very kind of Beaumont to give us the money. So it's a letter thanking them. And I believe that's it. County. Which one?
Two more.
Well,
two more communications.
Oh, two more communications.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. You're right.
They're proclamations. Yeah, okay. Boy, you had me worried there for a second.
Me too.
Yeah. Okay. County Commissioner's remarks. We missed you last month, but you're here now.
Thank you. Forgive me. I was gone in July and August. I was at Harvard Kennedy School of Government in July, and I had a little vacation in August, but I'm back. First of all, a little bit late, better late than never. I did bring you county directories. Quite honestly, they didn't come to me till July this year, and which is really late. We had to change vendors and go to the lowest price, and it wasn't necessary. It wasn't an efficient process. So I do want to bring everybody's attention to the cover of this. And there's an actual vote for a charter amendment of Lake Angeles. And it shows that there were 74 yes votes and 75 no votes. Mm-hmm. And what that illustrates, and our clerk gets, every vote counts. So I hope that people will always take it seriously to remember to take the time to vote. We have a great voting record here, but this is a real vote.
That's great.
And, mm-hmm. and our county clerk put it there, Lisa Brown, to remind us that. We're in the process of approving the Oakland County budget. And once again, we have a balanced budget for 3 years looking out into five. And the good news is that actually real estate values, property values have gone up higher than we projected in Oakland County overall. Some communities are better than others. And so that's actually helped our budget process. And as you recall, during the downturn, for many years, our employees, you know, I did, we took either voluntary or mandatory pay cuts. So finally, last budget there was an increase, and there's another increase for employees. But we're still behind what we were, and we're not competitive. But we are totally balanced. We've paid, we've budgeted for all of our medical, our legacy costs. We're a very unusual county mm-hmm. government unit. Within the budget, one of the things that we're restoring when things are tight, and we do it everywhere, is we've restored more funding to invest in infrastructure. You know, we kind of put on hold some of the buildings, things like that. And we are exploring the process of building a new animal care center. And over the last couple of years, I've worked very hard on this issue, heard people loud and clear. Right now, we have a very old structure that used to be near the trustee camp. It's near Lake Orion Plant. And several years ago, there's no air conditioning. Many people were upset. Someone donated some temporary air conditioning. We would need to put a couple million dollars into this very old building just to keep it up to process. So we are considering building a new building. The preliminary proposal is about $15 million. And I know that, you know, it's sticker shock. But we also know that the property we're sitting in now, the Lake Orion, is projected, we've done an estimate, could be sold for $4 to $5 million, which helps offset. We also know that we have a way to handle the debt service in about 6 or 7 years when some other money comes, you know, bonds are paid off. So looking at the package, it's starting to go through the whole committee process, and I'll keep you posted. I know that I've heard from many people already that they think it's a great investment, but again, we've started the bonding process for the building. We haven't appropriated because we fear that bond rates are going to go up, mm-hmm. So it is starting. I do want to talk about regional transit. You're going to hear me talking about this issue. There will, I'm part of a group planning another regional educational forum on Sunday, November 8th. It is being coordinated through the Metropolitan Congregation of Coalition of Congregations. And there are many different constituency, university presidents, students, multiple mayors, and so forth, coming forward to educate people. And hopefully the draft proposals for the regional transit plan will be presented, and there will be more opportunity for people to give feedback. And again, it's an educational program. No one's endorsing anything, but we want people to understand what could go before voters in 2016. Finally, I just want to talk a little bit about the DIA salary increases. So, as we all know, one of the things that I do as county commissioner is I put a lot of ballot language before the voters. We, as county government, have to vote on putting a millage before voters in many cases. So, if we created a arts authority, and we do have a couple of Oakland County appointees to the Arts Authority, and that Arts Authority, like the Zoo Authority, the Great Lakes Water Authority, they are the entity that oversees the public funding, and that they vote, you know, they make approval, vote how to spend that funding. And roughly there's about $23 million of public funding that comes in through that millage. So unfortunately, right after the bankruptcy, the DIA announced that they were going to do pay raises for their leaders, which they had withheld for several years, and there was a public uproar, how dare you after bankruptcy, and so forth. The county commissions amended the arts contract in June, saying that should you want to raise salaries for your leadership, the Arts Authority needs to vote on it, public needs to be aware of it, you know, there needs to be, you know, public notification. So they did do that. They did follow the contract, you know, the amendment, you know, in this last go-round. So it at the Arts Authority, and we said you can't use public money, and, you know, they got money donated. So they didn't violate any legal issues, but the perception, you know, people are still upset. So there were several resolutions introduced in the Oakland County Board of Commissioners. They're going to be heard in General Government Committee. One of them is suggesting to the Arts Authority, don't vote for this. The other one is trying to encourage Lansing to create legislation that mandates them to follow Open Meetings Act because they're getting public dollars. So that will be heard in General Government Committee. I'm going to go and listen to it. So, but I wanted to educate people so that you understand this. And if you've read the Cranes article, we are by no means, part of this is making us competitive in the marketplace. You know, we are, you know, making the salaries. So it's not, yes, they are high salaries, but within the art world, we're not out of sync. We were actually, we're below without it. Any questions for me?
Any questions for Commissioner? Very good.
Thank you.
Another good report as usual. Thank you very much. Now comes a time for public participation to speak about something that's not on the agenda. Seeing none, it is closed. Now we have a couple proclamations. We have a request to proclaim the month of September as National Recovery Month. And this is something I think that again, Oakland County has some responsibility for. And they're asking us to join in creating a proclamation. And I think what's the commission's pleasure? You read the proclamation. You want to hear the words?
Mr. Mayor, I'd make a motion that we approve the proclamation as submitted.
Okay, September 25th is National Recovery Month. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. There is another proclamation. It's please accept the invitation to join an exciting community-driven collaboration declaring September. No, that's the same one. I beg your pardon. This is Detroit chapter of the UNA-USA organization, and this is the Board of Directors of the Greater Detroit Chapter of the United Nations Association requests that the Huntington Woods City Commission place on the next meeting agenda issuing an official proclamation recognizing the United Nations on the 70th anniversary of its creation on October 24th. And that's what they're requesting us to do that, and we have a proclamation. United Nations was founded and established October 24th in the aftermath of a devastating world war. United Nations as an international organization of nations committed to giving peace a more secure foundation amid the threat of nuclear war and regional conflicts through its peacekeeping mission. And whereas the United Nations enhanced the quality of life for people worldwide through a myriad of programs that support child development, protect human rights, safeguard the environment, provide emergency and disaster relief, to name a few. And whereas the United Nations celebrates its 70th year of service to the community on October 24th, 2015, now therefore be it resolved that the City Commission of the City of Huntington Woods does here proclaim the day of October 24th, 2015 as United Nations Appreciation Day. Is there a motion?
Second.
I think if we were going to read one, we should have read them both, but that's my opinion. I tried.
Well, I can go back and read the other one.
Yes, I just think that it would be nice to
take them. I read the short one. The other one was much longer.
I was wondering if that was your logic.
That was
read,
it, yeah.
Read half of it, maybe.
Yeah, yeah. Well, Substance Use Recovery, National Recovery Month, Substance Use Recovery is important for individual well-being and vitality, as well as for families, communities, and business. I believe everyone facing substance use disorder deserves the benefits of recovery. Friday, September 25th, has been designated for Oakland County's 8th Annual Substance Use Recovery Celebration and Walk. Substance use disorders occurs when the recurrent use of alcohol and or drugs causes clinically or functionally significant impairment, such as health problems, disability, and failure to meet responsibilities of work, school, and home. A couple of others, and whereas use disorder recovery benefits individuals with substance use disorders by focusing on their abilities to live, work, learn, and fully participate and contribute to our society, and also enriches the culture of our community. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the City of Huntington Woods the Oakland County Mental Health Authority, the Office of Substance Abuse Services, along with the Oakland County Health Division, hereby recognizes September 2015 as National Recovery Month. ACMA calls upon our citizens, government agencies, public and private institutions, business and schools to recommit our state to increasing awareness and understandings of substance use and the need to appropriate and access services to promote recovery. Declare this date the September 2015. Thank you, Mary. I should have done that.
It's important that we, thank you.
Mr. Mayor, may I make a comment on the UN proclamation?
Mm-hmm. Well, that's already been approved.
I'm the one who sent it to you.
Hasn't. Okay. Okay.
Just an invitation.
I read it.
David Sloan, 8050 Lincoln Drive, Huntington Woods, Michigan. I am the president of the United Nations Association of Greater Detroit. I'm also a UN dad. My son serves with the UN overseas. Mm-hmm. So I want to thank you very much for this proclamation and recognizing the 70th anniversary of the UN. We are having a program on October 25th, Sunday, from 2 to 4:30 at the International Institute to honor the United Nations Day. We will have speakers from New York coming in, peacekeepers, to discuss something that is very new this year. It's called the Sustainable Development Goals that the General Assembly will be adopting later this month.
One thing, you said October 26th. This says October 24th as the day.
Yes.
It is the 24th. Okay.
United Nations Day. Our program is the next day.
Oh, okay.
October 25th at International Institute.
Okay.
And we will be celebrating these new 17 Sustainable Development Goals, which are set for the next 15 years to put an end to poverty, hunger, to take urgent action on climate change and gender equality. So once again, I want to thank the commission.
Thank you. Thank you for your comments. I believe we had a motion, but I don't think we approved it.
Not yet.
Yeah. Okay. All in favor of the motion, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Okay. Now we have a regular business. The first is a walk-run permit. Amy, would you care to start us off on that, please?
Yep. This is a new application. I know that there was a set amount of walks and runs that are pre-approved. This is a new application that had come in, so we'll bring it back before the commission to see whether or not you wanted to add an additional event. And Henry is here to give us a little bit more information about the event and whether or not it would be strictly on sidewalks or whether or not there'd be road closures required for this walk.
So I'm Henry, and for my mitzvah project, for my bar mitzvah, I've decided that I wanted to help raise money for an organization that sends kids to camp that are underprivileged and can't afford it. Because every summer I'm lucky enough to get sent to camp and I don't have to worry about the financials and paying for it, and I wanted to give other kids opportunities to do that. And by doing that, I was thinking about doing a run or a walk in Huntington Woods to raise money for it. And the sidewalk and the street matter was that it was really close to like Woodward and 10 Mile, and I was just concerned about the amount of people and the traffic.
Mm-hmm. Does that mean that you're going to do this, you're proposing to do this just on sidewalks?
It would be ideal to have like some of the streets closer to the busy streets, if that would be okay to do.
Well, the history has been, we had a lot of walks.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people asking for walks, all with good causes, and your cause is a great one. I like it very much. But the problem is that we also have people that object to having their access to the streets blocked off and have streets blocked and things of that nature. So I don't remember exactly when we passed the rules, but it's been quite a few years ago now that we would limit them to the ones that existed. Now, special cases, that's something that the commission here would have to look at this and think it is. I think if you, you know, if you can give us any sort of an indication that it will stay out of the streets and it won't be necessary to block streets, then there might be some sympathy for your cause, because it's a great cause. But I think we have to see what the commission's thoughts are on this.
Can I ask a quick question on Henry's mom? In terms of keeping people walking on the sidewalk isn't an issue. I think we were concerned about people crossing the street, right? So how do we make sure it's fine for people to walk on the sidewalk? That's not an issue at all. We just want to make sure nobody gets hurt crossing streets. Mm-hmm. So how in the past have you managed that?
Well, generally what people have done when they cross streets is they will have people stand there right. to slow down the traffic or stop the walkers if their vehicle's coming.
So we as volunteers.
So you would have to have volunteers to do that.
Okay.
And I think the Public Safety Department would accept that as an alternative, as a way to do it.
Okay.
And if you can do that, and I think I don't know of any of the events that I've walked in, like the Run Walk Boom, I know every street corner there's somebody, you know, looking out for people. Right. But usually by the time I come, everybody's tired, so. It's slow.
I've got a question. Is this something, a one-time only event that you're planning?
Well, this is, right now it is, but I was wondering if I could, like, do it annually, maybe, because this is the time of year that kids sign up for camp, and that would be a good thing to do in the fall.
Perhaps it's maybe you could, if the commission agrees to it, it would be like a test this year to see how it works, and we can go from there. Is that
Henry?
So I'd like to hear what the commission.
How likes. Many people do you think might walk?
75 to 100.
Okay, and would any of them be from Huntington Woods?
I think the majority of them would be.
Okay.
I have a lot of friends, like 30 friends. But then also bringing people from the Birmingham and Franklin and West Bloomfield area.
We're not sure we want that.
90%.
Not as good as us.
I'm joking. That's.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, sir.
I do have one other question. One thing that we like to do is notify the neighbors along the walk route that this is going to happen and what time it's going to happen. Would you be willing to have a volunteer group pass out a flyer that would in advance let them know that this is happening?
Yeah, I think that would be a good idea. Thank you.
I have a question. Henry, when I was looking at the information that they sent us, and you want to have this for kids that can't afford camp, so with the monies, I don't see the information on the camp and how that's all going to be handled.
Oh, so I'm working with the owner of this organization called Camp for Kids. His name is John Garu. Uh-huh. And he's already tried to set up a page, like if I do the walk or not, for donations. And all those donations go straight towards their organization. And all that money will pull into kids that get sent to 6 different camps in Wisconsin. So,
is it for all kids or what kids?
I think it's mainly aimed towards the St. Louis kids in that area, near.
You have to qualify for it. They have to have economic need.
Uh-huh.
It doesn't just go to a pool up to the camp. So, it goes specifically for kids scholarships.
So it's kids not from this area, but.
No.
Okay.
Yeah, it's kids, because he lives in Denver. And so he was looking at a lot of states to put the money towards, and St. Louis had the most, like, underprivileged kids.
Uh-huh.
And so he worked with a lot of their schools to talk to the kids that really couldn't afford it. And he worked with, like, their principals and their counselors.
Okay, and would we need any extra police presence? Would that be a cost that we would incur?
We have one of a public safety officer could maybe
since
tell
we
us.
We have someone standing back there, maybe.
Bill Cuddy, Lieutenant, the Public Safety Department. Just listening to the proposal, a couple issues. One, when a race comes through the interior part of our town, it's the organizer's responsibility to provide marshalling at intersections, not the Public Safety Department. For runs, in the past, we provided maybe a lead car or a trail car for the event. That's typically for runs, not for walks on the sidewalk. And if I heard you correctly, you were suggesting maybe some route along Woodward and 10 Mile?
I think what I did it was like the street parallel to it. So I was just worried about people that turn off of there and come in.
As long as if you don't have people walk along Woodward or 10 Mile, then you do not have to include Royal Oak.
Yeah.
If you go there, that's actually
mm-hmm. No. It's all in Huntington Woods boundary.
Very good.
I think you understood the message that you're going to have to provide marshalling, as he calls it.
Mm-hmm.
That's very important. If we don't do that, then you're setting yourself up for trouble as well.
And I guess I would like to see more information on the organization that would be getting the funding, and you know, because we don't really know where the funding. We know it's a great cause in that, but in order for us to vote on this, we have to make sure that.
The money's going to the right place.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. So, should I forward you the contact?
The information or more information on the organization that you chose for the mm-hmm. funding to go to, and sort of how is the criteria set?
So,
to ensure that we know that kids who really need it are going to get mm-hmm. the money, and how much of the money from the walk goes there, and you know,
yeah.
that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
We want to make sure that, you know, that your walk is a good one.
Is this a national organization?
Camp
for All Kids?
I think so.
Okay. Well, the way I look at it is, we're here to consider the request of the proponent, which is you. It's not our job, in my view, to go behind it and decide whether or not we approve of the particular charity. I think as a city commission, we would take it on faith that you're coming here in good faith. You're looking for a civic event permit to have a walk to support an organization. We have lots of these throughout the year, and so what I would do is move that we grant the civic event permit to Mr. Cantor for his walk on October 18th, 2015. But also request that you do provide to the city manager information on the organization, so that we do know a little bit more about who they are. But like I said, a young, articulate person like you comes in, stands up for something, and stands up for himself. And frankly, it impresses me quite a bit. So I want to be the one that makes the motion to approve it. But I do agree with my colleague that probably be nice to know
yeah.
a little bit something. For example, we have a run for the zoo coming up, and you know, we know what it's for. There's a number of health-related runs that we have throughout the year. We know what they're for, but you know, we don't ask to see them bring us in there.
Mm-hmm.
Incorporation papers and things like that, but just, you know, generally a little bit more information, which I assume you're going to have to put out anyway
yeah.
to get people to go on your walk.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, they may like you, but why are they going to go on your walk? So I would move that we grant the civic event permit.
Support.
I have actually two logistical concerns. The first is that if it is relegated to the sidewalk, you have to make it clear it's not a run.
Yeah.
It's just a walk. The second is the parking. If you really expect 75 to 100 people to come, that's a lot of people in one neighborhood that doesn't have a parking
mm-hmm.
lot. So maybe we need to work with public safety to see if there would be a different
yeah.
start-off location
oh.
and ending location that would accommodate the parking.
So I was thinking about that,
mm-hmm.
and when I sent out my e-vite or whatever, I'll be notifying people. All the Huntington Woods people, which will be the majority, I think it's very easy for everyone to walk to come. So I think I would let everyone know to not drive if they live in Huntington Woods. Mm-hmm. I think that people would respond.
You could work with that nice Lieutenant Cudney back there.
Yeah, don't.
That, yeah, that's called a warm-up.
Don't send out an e-vite yet.
I won't.
Okay.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can I suggest that before you send your e-vite out, meet with Lieutenant Cudney, because you might want to change your route so it's a safer route, it will not be where there are a lot of cars. And if you maybe started at a different location than people that drive here would be able to start and park nearby. And that guy's pretty nice. And you might actually know him from school.
Maybe. Probably a lot of elementary school talks.
I'd also, I'd like clarification from the commission that this is a one-time only event, and if he wants to do it in subsequent years,
sure.
He need to come back.
Absolutely.
It's not included in the...
It's a one-time.
The list of pre-approved.
Yeah, and if it's a success, you know, reason for you to think it won't be bigger and better or there'd be any issue going forward.
Thank you.
Then you can always say, well, you approved it last year.
But now the question is, do you then, if you do it next year, do you have to get bar mitzvahed again?
Okay.
No.
No?
Okay. Hopefully not. That's going to take a lot of work.
I'll think of something else.
It's too expensive.
Yeah.
Okay.
So our motion is subject to the city manager's final approval of the route and the
logistics
organization that
yeah.
he is contributing to.
I would accept that as a friendly amendment.
Yeah.
Though we have a moratorium in place. Okay.
That what?
So this is an exception.
This is not a
mark.
Yeah. Yes.
This is a walk.
Okay. Are we ready to vote? All in favor of the so vote, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Motion carried.
Thank
so,
you.
So you know what you know you have your marching orders. You got to talk to her and you got to talk to him and get working at it because time is short.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, the next is to amend Article 4, Blight Control, Chapter 14, Environment, the Code of Ordinances of the City of Huntington Woods by amending Section 1488, Control of Blight and Blighting Factors, to amend the time period mandated for removal of unlicensed or inoperative vehicles. We've had for years and years and years and years that you can't leave an unlicensed or unordered vehicle more than 30 days, I believe, is what the ordinance says. This proposal is to change that to 5 days. Because you see a lot of people that will put a car in the driveway and just leave it there. And it creates problems. So
or
I think
or a wrecked vehicle.
Or a wrecked vehicle, yeah.
And
so,
I'd like to suggest an amendment. Mary and I went over this ordinance earlier today, and we think it needs to be clear that this would only apply to private residential property rather than public property, not public, I'm sorry, commercial property because of the collision shop. So we would add the word leased, rented, or occupied, I'm sorry, the section shall apply to any blighting factor located in any open area on residential private property.
Yeah, we're going to straighten, just say, is this the last sentence you're talking about?
Yes.
Say it again, please.
This section shall apply to any blighting factor located in any open area on residential private property clearly visible from a street.
What if a car is parked in the parking along Woodward in front of the office buildings?
Good point. We were trying to exclude any conflicts with the collision shop.
Yeah, it'd be a little tough for them.
Yes.
And your business is fixing wrecks.
It's fixing wrecks, yeah. It's a little hard to...
A little tough for them. Well, I don't see, with the exception of Armitage, what commercial entity would want a wrecked or abandoned vehicle parked in front of it for more than 5 days. I mean, I'm struggling to find the image doctor that would say that was a good thing.
That's true, but then the word residential would preclude us from taking action on that in those circumstances.
Well, you want to build in an exception that says unless it's a business that involves the repair or maintenance of motor vehicles, because that would only be one. That would be in our whole city. It's Armitage, and unless we were to get another because the BP station, first of all, they don't do repairs, and they're not in Huntington Woods. The flower shop, the last time I saw, doesn't do motor vehicle repairs. The daycare center doesn't.
How about the offices along Woodward?
Yeah, but they don't do automotive repairs.
But somebody could park a car there and leave it.
Right, well, that's what I'm saying. So why don't we just restrict it to businesses involved in the maintenance or repair of motor vehicles?
Okay.
Exception.
Let me take this back to Carol, and we'll get a revised ordinance.
And revisit it next.
Just wait until next month to consider it.
Yes.
Is there a motion to table?
I move to table.
Not to be funny or anything, but we have had instances where cars are on blocks and they have used wheels for evidence. Now I'm just saying, you know, and they don't get them back maybe within the days. I don't know how long it takes. I was going to ask Officer Cudney, how long does it take? Because I heard it sometimes takes a while to get those cars back. And I know there was a car on Borgman on blocks for a while. So until the wheels were returned. That was just something else I thought about on the way. I know it sounds crazy, but you know, it would hate for them to have the wheels, so, you know, and then have a ticket on top of it.
Well,
I know we can use good judgment in that, but I think that precludes that, but I just wanted to make sure that we understand that.
Mm-hmm.
We could invoke judicial discretion if there obviously was a reason why they needed
the
5 days needed to be extended.
Right. Okay. As long as we're taking it back, might as well bring that up.
And it, generally one of the items is that it had to be currently valid licensed. Quite often, if it's something like this, probably has a valid license. But sometimes the ones that we really want to get rid of are the ones that the licenses are expired.
You're probably right. That's
a
good point.
Yeah.
Good point, Mayor. Yeah.
Okay, but is there a motion? Motion to table. I'm not supposed to discuss it.
I made a motion to table.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. It will be brought back to the next commission meeting. Okay, the next item. Amy, would you want to handle this, or should Tony handle this?
This is a bid award for a dump truck and the dump body to go on it. We are part of a 21-city consortium. They went out to bids. Rochester Hills was the lead on this. They went out for bids for the specific dump truck and body that we were looking for. And they are recommending that the bid be awarded to Wolverine Freightliner and Truck and Trailer Specialists for a total of $152,470. And this is a budgeted item, and it is coming in below the budget.
And I think I called the city manager, and I think she was going to ask Tony to make sure that we have, when it goes out for an RFP, that we have the bids in front of us like we used to do,
mm-hmm.
and then we can look at the bids and see what bid this is, if it was the lowest bid, and who was the better help, because we sort of know those names, and then we can actually ask a question on, okay, why did we choose this one over this bid? So
we are being part of a system that does all that.
I think that's very, I think it's a logical request. These are reasonably elaborate bids for these vehicles.
I understand.
Because there are so many parts and pieces that go into the not the manufacturer, but putting it together differently in each jurisdiction. So I do agree, Mary, that it certainly does make sense to have that before you. I did put the award there I gave you tonight, the award of the bid, which was to in the Rochester Hills RFP. But I think that's a reasonable request and something that we need to endeavor to do. It's a very simple thing to do.
It was best practice. We used to do it.
Absolutely.
So
and I will certainly do that. I would request here in this case that that said that this what is a duplicate truck, essentially, to the one we just ordered in order to accommodate the V-body in case we have an issue in the wintertime with a breakdown and so forth, be approved by the City Commission through what was a public bid through Mitten. So there were at least six bidders on this bid, and I am very comfortable. Jay and I spent an inordinate amount of time reviewing all the specifications to make sure that it matched what we need, which is different than what other jurisdictions need. So I would agree with you, Mary. I think you deserve to have in front of you that data, and that is going to be done. And I will send it to you.
And then just make that, I want to make sure that we have it as a budget, things that come before us, that it is a, that is a
right.
line item in the budget.
Right.
So we know that this isn't something that you, it's in there. It's so we can make sure that when we have those that come forward in the future. So it's sort of easy to know that, oh yeah, this was in the budget. You know,
what I would suggest then is we add that to the resolution and just say as per the 2015-16 budget.
Budget. So.
And that'll handle it.
Thank you, Tony.
You bet.
Mr. Mayor, I'm going to make a motion with respect to item number 3 that we authorize the City of Huntington Woods to enter the contractual agreement with Wolverine Freightliner and Truck and Trailer Specialties for the purchase of a 2015 Freightliner chassis for the amount of $86,772 and a dump body for $65,698 for a total cost of $152,470. The city finance director has indicated he will make available the specific bid documents, but that's they're available anyway. So based on his representations and the city manager's statement, I would move that we go ahead with this bid.
Support.
Okay. Some good comments, Commissioner.
Thank you.
I think it is good. I think the one thing that I found in the discussion with Tony is what we're trying to do is economize here. We got a truck with a dump body on it. Okay? In the wintertime, we're going to put salt down. We have a V bed that will fit within the bed of the dump truck and can be a very quick changeover, and we'll be ready to put down salt. So you don't have two trucks, one with a V body and one with another.
Exactly.
So it's a good bit of economy from that standpoint, too. I think it's a good idea. Okay, any other discussion?
No.
I should say
for everybody, but I meant not for me.
Okay. Hearing no further discussion, all in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Okay, we have another similar bid award. This is for public safety vehicles.
Yep, this is to purchase two new patrol vehicles and also takes into account the cost for the changeover to put new gear into it. Unfortunately, we're not able to take the gear out of the cars that we were replacing because those are Crown Victorias. They're going to have to put all new equipment into the new patrol vehicles because they are Ford.
Same thing.
Escapes?
Yes.
Explorers.
Oh, yes. I apologize. That's right. Explorers.
Okay.
Right.
Right.
I see they look the same to me.
And this was another cooperative bid through Macomb Township. So the price for the vehicles, $26,180. The cost for the vehicle changeover is $9,000. Traditionally, we don't bid out the cost of the changeover. But we did contact, Public Safety did contact a number of vendors, and they were only a couple hundred dollars apart between the lowest bid and the next highest bid, which happened to be Canfield Corporation. Canfield has a much better reputation for getting things done expediently, and we don't want to be in a position where we get a new patrol vehicle, but we're unable to use it for 3 or 4 months because of the changeover. So. Public Safety thought it was in the city's best interest to go with the Canfield Corporation, even though it was a couple hundred dollars more because of their reputation for changeover.
And I also contacted the city manager on this and said also that, you know, same thing goes the last time we used
Absolutely.
To always get, you know, a breakdown.
Absolutely.
What you and Jay looked at and what maybe you and
I entirely agree.
The chief
yep.
used to look at mm-hmm. was there. And then that
well,
$200 extra you could tell us. Now, I know we've used the place in Owosso because I remember that. But,
oh, yeah.
And I know, can I just ask the exceptions to competitive bidding? I'm sorry. on here, does that mean that some things just can't be bid out in this process? Exceptions, what does that mean?
The commission can always make an exception to that.
So is that why you chose the
$200 more? And the reason I said that instead of adding them together, because I wanted the commission to understand that there were enough anomalies in the changeover that would make it difficult to bid in the first place, and ask that you look at the exception available in the ordinance.
Okay.
Okay, is there a motion to accept?
So moved.
Second.
Any further discussion? This will have an all fleet of all the new vehicles in a couple of months.
It's expensive, right? Evening, that's for sure.
Yeah. Okay, all in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carried. Okay, the next item is a matter considered to recess and close the session in order to discuss union negotiations.
Mr. Mayor, I'll make a motion that we recess into closed session immediately following the regular city commission meeting to discuss union negotiations, and we will reconvene the regular meeting following the closed session.
Okay, is there a second to that?
Second.
We have the ability to reconvene if we so choose, correct? Or do we have to do it?
We have to come back
if it's stated. Okay, all right.
You can take
that's
no
the way it is.
And,
yeah. Okay, it takes a roll call. Or any discussion to that? It takes a roll call vote.
Aye.
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 Aye. Let the record show it was unanimous vote. So after the end of the meeting, we will take a break and then close. Okay, reports and minutes. The Senior Advisory Committee minutes is the only ones that we have. Is there any questions or comments? Looks like they're working well. Reports are received and filed. Next item is warrant 301. Is there a motion to approve subject audit?
So moved.
Second.
Anyone have any questions, comments about any of the items on the agenda or on the list? Tony's getting better and better at making these readable.
Well, with the change in individuals working here at City Hall, we've got to get back to, Ricky had a certain way, as I mentioned to you this afternoon, of writing descriptions down. And it's funny how if you don't do that for a length of time, you get a certain cadence, you know, in terms of what you say is a DTE bill or whatever the case may be. So you have to put a description in, and we're going to get a little better at it as we move along here, because Ricky did that, and Ricky is now not with us. So give us a month or two, and we'll get that down pat.
Good. Always room for a little change. Yeah? Okay, any questions or comments about anything on here? Hearing nothing, all in favor of the motion say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Opposed? Same sign. Motion approved. Okay, second opportunity for public participation. Okay, hearing none. City manager's report.
Sure, just a couple of quick comments here from the DPW. They would like to let residents know that the Environmental Advisory Committee and the BART Board have scheduled three different workshops coming up in October and November. First one sounds really interesting. They're bringing in a speaker from the National Weather Service who's going to talk about weather trends and a little bit about what happened on August 11th. That will take place on September 30th. That'll be followed up by a sustainable landscapes workshop, and then another one to bring residents up to date about the Great Lakes Water Authority. And they also asked me to remind you that even though it's September and the leaves are going to start to fall, leaf pickup will not begin until October 19th. So please, no leaves in the street until the 19th of October. You can go ahead and put them in your yard waste containers, and we'll pick them up that way. And from the Recreation Department, they asked me to remind you that registration is underway right now. The classes are going to start September 21st. So if you're interested in something, you need to get signed up for it quickly. The walking and running track behind the recreation center is scheduled to be resurfaced beginning September 14th. The area will be temporarily fenced off while the job is completed. If they had good weather, the job should be completed in 4 days. So the middle of September, the track will be down. And lastly, the inline skate rink at Vale Jones Park is scheduled to be resurfaced with the donation from the men's club, and work will begin on that shortly. And that's it.
Any questions for the city manager? Okay. Thank you very much. Commissioner's remarks. We start with Commissioner Olsman tonight.
Nothing tonight, Mr. Mayor, except that last month I wasn't aware we had a meeting before the onset of Rosh Hashanah, so I wished all those who were celebrating.
So you had a
happy and healthy
New Year. You jumped the gun a little bit, did you?
So I renew my good wishes to those celebrating Rosh Hashanah, our residents of Huntington Woods.
Okay. Mayor Pro Tem White.
Same goes for me. I'll put a little different spin on it. Lashana Tova, Tikatevu, Healthy Happy New Year. May you all be written in the good book, those of you who celebrate the new year. Also, be very careful. We encourage our students in the Burton School to walk, and also the students at the high school to walk, so you'll see them crossing 11 Mile Road. Please do not rush through the city. You know, there's no place where you have to go. I know. I noticed there's been an uproar of people who are blowing stop signs and yield signs. Don't do that. There's no place that you have to go that's important, that you can injure someone, because that will forever be in your thing. So it's just not worth it. Slow down, keep your eyes open, and be safe. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks.
Happy holidays coming up. I also would like to echo what Mary said. And now that evening is getting earlier, if you're going to ride a bike, make sure you have a light, make sure you wear light-colored clothing, and if you go to public safety, they will give you some reflective types of material. We have not had anybody killed. We haven't had cars crash at intersections, but we don't want them first. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Soon you'll be receiving a flyer in your door from the Men's Club and Women's League announcing their apple cider and donut sale. You can have your cider and donuts delivered directly to your door if you fill out that form, or you can find them on various corners throughout the city on October 3rd. The only other thing I have is that the citywide golf outing sponsored by the Men's Club, which is a fundraiser for the Scholarship Fund, is on September 29th. You can sign up at the Rec Center. They're also looking for hold sponsors if anyone's interested. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, all I can say is that it's been a good meeting. I'm glad you're all here. And we will now adjourn to a special meeting, closed session.